Welcome back to another grocery haul. Well, we're back into it, and we have absolutely covered the bench top this week with food. We've spent $202, I believe is the grand total, and we have gone to town. Went online this week again, enjoying that experience. The app is very easy to use. It saves a hell of a lot of time during the week. You can add to your list and take away. You keep an eye on your budget so you don't run over. Really budget and time friendly. They do a pretty good job. The app also offers you the opportunity to look back at what you've previously bought and add anything that you may have missed with a bit of a forgotten to add to your trolley prompt just before you go into the checkout. So we do online, we pay our annual fee, works out under $2.50 a week. If you're interested in a 30-day free trial, it's in the description box below.
Let's head up the back. We've got 6 litres of milk this week, but we've actually been out of milk for a couple of days. So we've overstocked a little bit this week with milk. We've also got some peas to add to the freezer with some sweet potato chips. We've got a little bit of a challenge this week, Ali set me. So we're gonna try and get that sorted. Got some tasty cheese. We had to buy the Hillview this week, not the home brand. Got some coconut cream, which is part of the meals this week. Moving down, some baked beans. Baked beans are dear, they're $2.20 a tin. We used to get them and they're about $1.15. I'm not sure if that's across the country. However, I have noticed them going up in price. These guys here, Heart and Soul. There's some recipe bases. There's a massam curry there, just tucked behind the butter chicken. They're on special this week. And then just to that, we've got some curried sausages and the Master Foods brand, which we've had previously, which we really enjoy. Tucked behind there, there's always the nutritious Maggi 2-minute noodles. They're always handy just to have in the pantry when everyone wants a quick meal. Sliding down this way, we've got the beef sausages. It was a buy any 2 for $12, so we jumped on board there. They'll get used this week. Some spaghetti, 89 cents or 90 cents there. Ali wanted to try these Baby Bell original cheeses. I'm not sure how they're gonna go. They were seen in lunchboxes, I believe, so we've jumped on board. Let me know in the comments below if you have tried these and what you think. Sliding across, got some blueberries, fairly standard. Some ham steaks, that's going to be a part of our meal challenge going forward this week, as well as our Asian style salad kit. Now, I didn't actually order this one. It was a substitute. I believe I just put through just a crunchy salad. Clearly they didn't have it, so they've thrown in a bit of Asian style this week. Up a bit further, we've got the diced tomatoes, 3 tins of that. Some more butter, chalk coated classic sticks, the home brand. I think they work out to be 35 cents a ice cream. As you can see, the gestational diabetes adventure has come to an end. Ali's already hopped into one of those. To the right, we've got some low GI bread, 2 loaves of that. Bit of a funny one behind here. We've got the Odd Bunch Lebanese cucumbers. I believe we were ordering 2. And we've ended up with 2 bags. So I think we've got $8 worth of cucumbers there. That's a bit of an online mishap. We've got the free range Australian chicken. That worked out at $16 a kilo. That'll get used up this week. Strawberries, still seem to be a plentiful supply of strawberries. So we've grabbed 2 punnets of those. We've got the pears, which we still enjoy. We've got some bananas. Not sure if you can see that, but they are very green this week. It'll be interesting to see how they ripen up, because they are still very green. The rolled oats and the Vitabrits, which I believe were on special this week as well. Heading right a little bit further, we're stocking up some of our basics. Wholemeal self-raising flour, some plain flour, and we've got some premium self-raising flour, White Wings. We did order the home brand or the essentials brand. However, they didn't have any, so they've substituted us with the White Wings. Coming down this way, brown sugar is another one that we were just about out of. These all rounders, these washed red potatoes, didn't order these either. Ordered a 2 kilo bag of, I believe, just the regular white potatoes, but they didn't have those. So we're gonna give these a bit of a try. Broccoli, actually cheaper to buy the fresh broccoli than it is the frozen this week at Woolworths. It's not always a bad idea, particularly online. Easy to do, just flick between the frozen and the fresh and see if there's some money to be saved there. Under there, two dozen eggs. We go through eggs fairly quickly in this house between breakfasts and cooking cakes and muffins and slices. I'll pop him out of the way there. We've got some asparagus to go with our meals, and we bought these avocados. So as we normally do, we'll pop the bananas and the avocados next to each other in the fruit bowl, and hopefully they can both ripen up. We've got some odd bunch crazy carrots, they call them. Taste just like the regular carrots, but they're just a little bit misshapen. Don't worry too much about that. And then we've got some tomatoes. We've only got three. Once again, if you're a bit of a regular of this channel, you'll realise that we do like our tomatoes. However, they are very dear at the moment, and I think that continues. That's why we only get a couple. So as you can see, there's $202 worth of groceries to do our meals this week. Hope everyone's having a good week, and we'll catch you next week.
Rightio. In the process of getting all our groceries put away, I've noticed we're missing a couple of things. We're missing some blue ribbon ice cream. I'm guessing Ali probably put that on the list, because I certainly didn't. And we're missing some fish, which is integral to one of this week's meals. So I'll have to chase them up with wings.